Good evening. This is Luc Sala from Myster Media. Tonight, we're speaking with Peter Rosen about a concept, a dream, a vision that he calls Creativity Cafe. Welcome, Peter.
Thank you very much.
To start with it, you look Californian.
Okay.
Are you?
No, I feel like a world citizen, actually.
But where are your roots?
My roots are in Maui. My home and my heart and all of my belongings are now in storage on Maui.
Now, Maui is where?
Maui is in Hawaii. It's the part of the Hawaiian Islands, one of them. And I moved there to rejuvenate, and I had a very mystical experience at that point, which committed me ever more to my vision of Creativity Cafe.
Because that's what you're doing now. You're traveling around Europe. You're doing workshops. We'll talk about that later. Talk with people and you spread, like an evangelist, the idea of a creativity cafe.
That's true.
Tell me what it is.
Creativity cafe is an environment where the community can gather physically, and even though they might not have the understanding or the technology resources that are so prevalent in today's world, we offer them assistance in understanding the new communication tools and to have fun with interactive entertainment. Both interactive.
Wait a minute. This sounds like you are implying internet and multimedia.
Well, that's part of it. We recognize that we're all storytellers and we all have our images and our stories and songs to share. Creativity Cafe is a forum for a creative person to express their creativity and for us to package it and market it for distribution with the internet in mind.
Now, the old idea of cafes, brown cafes we call them in Amsterdam, is that you go there, you order a few beers or a lot of beers, and you hang at the bar, and at best you tell stories and jokes.
Yes.
So what's the difference between that and your vision of a creativity cafe?
Creativity Cafe uses what we call facilitated networking. It's we put the resources of the community, the people that inhabit the cafe, our clients, we put them in touch with each other in ways that are mutually beneficial. So our object is to practice pronoia, not paranoia. Pronoia is the unsettling suspicion that somebody is conspiring behind your back to assist you.
To help you rather than...
To help you rather than impede your progress. They want for your success. And at Creativity Cafe, we will go out of our way to connect you with the resources you need to shine in the world.
The vision that comes up is Woodstock, or in Europe we have Glastonbury Festival. We
yes.
have... We just came from the Nieuwe Tijd, Eigen Tijds Festival, a New Age Festival,
yes.
where people do more or less the same. They do massage and they sing and they were painting and working with clay and whatever.
Yes.
Is that the environment you see?
Yes, all of this is very similar to a creativity cafe environment, only where in this festival you speak of, The presenters had their packages already planned and presented to an audience that at times interacted with them. We're asking the audience to come up with entertainment as much as we offer them something to feed their souls on. We ask them to give us, make the food. We provide with them the multimedia tools, the internet access, all the lights and the sound equipment, the video equipment, and we invite the artists in the community to come in and make use of these tools to tell their story or perform their art that they would have us experience.
You've been preaching this, but did it actually happen? Have you seen places where this concept of you, which is not, you call it Creativity Cafe, but in fact it is a new media environment that might happen in this cyber cafe or in even a dead festival?
That's exactly true. Creativity Cafe is more of an environment, as you say. And what creates that environment are the artists in the community. And each environment will be different according to its own culture. I envision many creativity cafes around the world. It could be part programming, or it could be a physical creativity cafe. Right now, we exist in cyberspace and touch down in physical reality whenever we can on our way to a permanent facility, hopefully in San Francisco, but perhaps it'll be first in Vienna, where we've been
invited. You say you all exist in cyberspace. Does that mean you have a website?
That's right. We have a website, and actually, the wonderful thing about the World Wide Web is that it equalizes the money situation with the haves and the have-nots. As long as you can have access to the internet and the World Wide Web, you don't need the wealth and resources of, say, a Sony corporation or a Magnavox or any of the major corporations that have websites of many, many pages. You can learn the tools and have a site equally as beautiful and reaching as many people with very little money.
Okay, well, it feels like you're going on your dream. Thank you for this. And now we go on to what you're coming to do in Amsterdam, which is you are actually making the Creativity Cafe happen on Sunday, June 8th. And the text I read is Amsterdam's funniest and wildest home video networking brunch.
That's right.
So it's going to happen at Myster at Leinbahnstraat 92 in the morning from 11 till 3 o'clock in the afternoon, and later on there will be dancing and what you call jamming.
Jamming, we'll have live music, and the networking brunch is an opportunity for video and filmmakers and people using the digital tools to come and share a little bit of their videotape that they've produced with an audience interactively. Again, we're using art as a catalyst for group interaction, like we do in all of our Creativity Cafe events. We're always trying to break the boundary between artist and audience so that the audience gets the feeling that they too are creative and as empowered as the artist.
But you're actually inviting people who have videos that are very funny to come and bring them.
Bring your videos down, show us a snip of your life, and let us get a clue of who you are. And that way we'll be able to maybe package your material or introduce you to somebody with whom you could collaborate. That's the point of Creativity Cafe, for you to tell your story and for us to help you market it and find collaborators.
And your admission fee is 11 guilders, which is kind of funny because the 11th of the 11th is what it's Fool's Day a little bit.
Well, a little bit, but you know why I did that? I had the vision of the Artist Resource Center, now called Creativity Cafe, on July 11th. And it was that day on Maui when there was a solar eclipse of the sun on July 11th, 11 years to the day that I was kept up all night with this vision of an Artist Resource Center where the most inspired and creative people could collaborate using all of this digital technology to make positive media for mass media distribution, with the hope that the world would somehow be influenced to be a happier, healthier, safer place by all these positive images in the world.
Well, that sounds great. Peter, 92. Thank you, Peter.
Thank you, Luc Sala.